Hello. In this video, I'm going to approximate the sizes of the Sun and the Moon, as well as get their distances from Earth without much of a maths process. And I'm going to do this by moving the Sun and the Moon about on screen until they best fit observations, measurements, and calculations. If you prefer to see all the maths, then there are plenty of videos on YouTube that explain the process in great detail. Right off the bat, I'm going to provide three well-established measurements, and all of these can be obtained in varying degrees of accuracy by almost anyone. The first given is the Earth's radius of 6371 kilometers. Most sane people will agree with this value. The second is the Moon's angular size, which is roughly half of 1 degree. The third is the angle between the Sun and the Moon when the Moon is exactly half lit and half in shadow. There was some old Greek guy about 2,000 years ago who claimed this angle was about 87 degrees, but the true value is more like 89.853 degrees. And it's this value that will show that the Sun is roughly 390 times further away from the Earth than the Moon is. Here I have a unit circle, that is to say it has a radius of 1. And tangent to it is this line, T. This is a typical textbook image showing the Earth, Sun and Moon during the Moon's first and last quarter phases. The angle we're interested in is angle theta, and it's already been given as 89.853 degrees. With a little bit of trig, we can work out how many times greater in length the hypotenuse is over the adjacent. So, with the adjacent side of this triangle always set to 1, the answer will always be the measured length of the hypotenuse. So in this example, where theta is 60 degrees, the Sun is exactly 2 moon distances away from Earth. And just to check this, sec theta is hypotenuse over adjacent, so that's 2 over 1, so sec 60 will equal 2. So using the calculator, we have 60, and use the secant function. And the answer is 2. If we type in 89.853 degrees, we get a value that's very close to 390. So what would a right triangle look like with a base of 1 and a hypotenuse of 390? Have a go at drawing it for yourself, and then you'll understand why textbooks depict pictures of the solar system in the way they do. The next observation is the solar eclipse. You'll notice that the Moon is always in front of the Sun, and it seems to match its angular size in many cases. As the Sun is 390 moon distances away from Earth, we can infer that the Sun's diameter is also about 390 times larger than that of the Moon. Next up is the lunar eclipse, and every once in a while, the Moon will travel through the Earth's umbral shadow. So what I'd like to do next is find out how many moons will fit side by side in that shadow. I've tackled this by drawing circles around the Moon and the Earth's shadow, and then comparing the two. For this photo, the radius of the shadow is divided by the radius of the Moon, and this answer tells us we can fit roughly 2.667 moons in the shadow. So let's give this example a try. So for this example, we got 2.7. The last example, we had 2.667. So they're roughly the same, about 2.7. Bringing it all together, we know that one, the sun is roughly 390 times larger than the moon. Two, the sun is roughly 390 moon distances away from the Earth. Three, the moon occupies roughly 0.52 degrees of a 360 degree sky. And four, the moon can fit roughly 2.7 times side by side in the Earth's umbral shadow during the Sun-Earth-Moon syzygy. To start off, I have eight moons taking up all 360 degrees of the sky at an orbit of about 100,000 kilometers away, the angular size of each being 45 degrees. But we don't want that. We want 0.52 degrees. So let me adjust that. So now I have 692 moons sitting side by side, 360 degrees around the Earth. When we switch the sun on, the Earth will be lit up and its umbral shadow will be cast. This checkbox here allows me to center the screen on this region here. And if you were to count the number of moons that sit side by side in this shadow, you'll see that there's about 13 of them. The last step involves changing the moon's orbital distance around the Earth. Increasing it means the sun and the moon get larger while the sun moves further away. So when I move the slider, this number will change and I'm aiming for just under 2.7. So let me compare values. I have about 1730 kilometers for the moon's radius. Google says 1737. For the moon's orbital distance, Google says 384,000 kilometers. I've got 381. For the sun's radius, I've got 674,000 kilometers. Google says 696,000. And for the distance, Google says 151 million kilometers, and I've got 149 million kilometers. So that's all within 1 or 2%. So hopefully you found this approximation simple and somewhat informative. But if you're feeling brave and want to know more about the math involved, then I'll leave some links in the description. Well, that's it for now. Please do remember to like, subscribe, and let me know what you think, and I'll catch you later.